सावित्री भाई फुले बॉर्न ऑन जनवरी 3rd ऑफ 1831 इन सतारा डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ महाराष्ट्र. When she married Jyotirao Phule, she was 9 and Jyotirao Phule was 13. At the time of her marriage, she was an illiterate, but Jyotirao Phule educated her while working in the field as a farmer. Jyotirao Phule's parents threatened to throw them out of their house, fearing the attack by the Orthodox society. At that time, society was not accepting the girls to be educated. It is considered as not good for the society. But he did not deter. He continued to teach her and completed the primary education. Then she enrolled for the higher studies with her brothers, with her relatives. And later on, she enrolled herself for the teacher's training in an institution run by Cynthia Farrar, an American missionary. In the year 1848, both the Phules, Jyotirao Phule and Savitribai Phule, started first school for the girls in India, and in that, 9 girls got enrolled. People threatened these couples, but it did not deter them to continue their effort. 9 girls become 25. And later on, Savitri Bhai Phule became the headmistress of the institute, and her classmate who studied with her in the earlier days, that is Fatima Sheikh, also joined her as a trainee. And their aunt, actually Sugana Bhai, is a person who has influenced both Jyotirao Phule and Savitri Bhai Phule, also joined this institution to teach girls. And that was the first school started in India by Savitri Bhai Phule. And she is considered as a mother of feminism in India. And also, she is the person who started the first girls' school in India. But this was not accepted easily by Orthodox society. They threw cowdung tomatoes and abused with filthy language, but it did not deter her in continuing her efforts. She told them that, "Brothers, I am doing noble job of educating your sisters. What you are throwing at me is not a cow dung, or the abuse which you are throwing at me is not a filthy language. I consider this as a blessings and petals of flowers. May God bless you." But even then, they threatened this lady, and at this time she was about to give up, but her husband Jyotirao Phule persuaded her not to give up. She continued, and while doing so, what she used to do is, every day she used to carry 2 saris with her to change the filthy laden sari at the school with the fresh one, and come back with the old filthy laden sari. And this has continued, and this led to the establishment of 18 schools between 1948 to 52. And these couples started many revolutionary things in India. Her husband, Jyotirao Phule, started Satyashodhaka Samaj to educate the people about the atrocities and about the truth of life. And then he considered humanity is the only truth which has to be prevailed in all the Hindu scriptures. He studied Hindu scriptures and found that this, what is Satya, is all humanity is same. And later, the Satya Shodhak Samiti was taken over by Jyotirao Phule. Then she continued to work for the atrocities against women and also the downtrodden. The family of Mali, this family belonged to a community of Mali, a downtrodden community in Maharashtra, adopted a Brahmin boy, Yashwantrao, who was born to a widow. Savitribai Phule worked with her entire family for the victims of plague and the downtrodden, and they built reservoirs for the benefit of all the people. At that time, the people were not allowed to take water from the common well, So they built the reservoirs and they were kept open for all the people. The entire family worked for the victims of plague. Unfortunately, while working for the plague, she fallen ill. So she worked for the abolish of the discrimination and unfair treatment based on caste and gender. The lady was uneducated, became educated by her husband Jyotirao Phule and became a teacher and founder of the first girls' school in India, and she has been considered as mother of Indian feminism. This lady is responsible for Balika Din in Maharashtra. This lady who worked for the plague victims become a victim of that and succumb to death.